yellow side. It's a new generation. It's a worldwide of party people. Get on the floor, darling. Get on the red wine.
Let me introduce you to my party people in the club. Hello, everyone out there. You are tuning in to Lesley on the Town, and we are live in the studio. I'm here today with award-winning KTVI-TV and KMOV-TV reporter Donn Johnson, as well as the voice of choice radio personality Sheila Reed. Thank you all for being here today.
Pleasure's mine.
Definitely.
Same here.
Oh, yes. Well, I'm glad for you to be on the show. It's a great pleasure. So we'll get to know a little bit about you, Donn. You have been well recognized in the broadcast world and the community and received many awards, including 4 Emmy Awards, over a half dozen awards from the St. Louis chapter of the Black Journalists Association, and you've been named one of St. Louis's 100 most inspiring people for your contributions in the community. You've achieved some wonderful things throughout your career. What inspired you to get into broadcast and communication, and what drives your passion?
I feel like Urkel. Did I do that? In all seriousness, I was inspired by all the people that came before me. You know, when I was a boy, there were only two broadcasters who were black on the radio when I was a boy, and I would to hear Spider Burke, and Edward G. Logan, and I would say, oh man, how do you get a job like that? And then later on, after I heard other broadcasters, I mean, it didn't matter, white, black, whatever, I would wonder how they got those jobs. So that is where my interest came from. And I would actually stand out in front of the house when I was a kid on Washington Avenue and just simply continue to say strike three for some reason, because I listened to Harry Carey all the time.
Oh, <yeah. laughs>
I would just say strike three, and I really wanted to be a sports broadcaster, but that never, I did some sports, but that never really worked out for me. So my inspiration were, starting with Spider Burks, and then along came, Father Time, Lou Times, and then Bernie Hayes, and Jimmy Bishop, and all these guys who came through town on the radio, and it's the kind of thing I wanted to do. So that really is how I started. And then with TV, when Julius Hunter came along, my good friend, God bless him, we realized, that, geez, we could actually do this.
Yes.
And of course, Julius acquitted himself very, very well. And then there were others, Al Sanders, who later went on to Baltimore and became a big newsman. He's gone now, God rest his soul. So I had a number of people who came before me that inspired me to do what I did.
Absolutely.
And they were some of the best in the world. I mean, Ron Nichols, I can start naming names. Yeah. The list goes on and on and on. And I know you're that they're people that you may never have heard of, but if you now you can Google them and you can find out who they are.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you even see some of their work.
Oh, yes.
And I was one of the first, well, I was the first black broadcaster on WIL Radio, which was a country radio station.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And I was there 6.5 years. And even did some disc jockey work there.
Wow.
And I'll tell you something about that. It gave me a new respect for country music.
Do you any line dancing?
No, but I met Dolly Parton and Willie Nelson and a bunch of these
that's
people who become
cool
international stars and have broken the bounds of country music, So, I gained a new respect for it. I mean, there were still some of the good old boys that were still there. But now, of course, country is much more sophisticated than it used to be and much more integrated. So,
It depends on what you're listening to
and who you're listening to, that kind of thing. But, they've modernized a bit. No more bangles and beads and cowboy hats and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Just as long as it's all in good fun.
Oh, yeah.
That's all
about
it. And Sheila, you've also had a very successful career in communications, and you've been recognized as the voice of choice in radio broadcasting since 1983. But how's that possible? You're only 24, right?
I celebrate my birthday.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh,
happy birthday.
Yes, my birthday's Saturday. We're both Aquariuses.
Oh, you did too?
Yes,
oh, happy birthday to you both.
That's yeah. Right.
I quit counting mine.
You barely
very
made
good.
It.
Yeah. Exactly.
But the voice of choice. I tell you, I was very honored when I first received my award from an organization called Us Girls at the time. I did some work for them, and they gave me that plaque, and it sort of carried with me all along. So
oh, wow.
I guess most people here in St. Louis and the surrounding areas do consider me the voice.
What
voice.
Is a lovely voice?
Well, you have a very lovely voice. You do.
Thank you.
You
so
do.
Much.
Have you sang as well? Sometimes people that have a great speaking voice also.
I've actually hit a few tunes at church,
okay.
in the choir, and in the shower. And a buddy of mine actually has a recording studio, so I've kind of played around in his studio at one time. I actually think I can sing. I think,
good.
You know, if I was given a little background, you know.
Well, don't look at me. I can't sing. Don't look at me. I couldn't carry a note in the box. You keep right on singing, Sheila.
Jazz at the Bistro featuring Sheila.
I actually sang for my mother's birthday once.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I whipped out with Pita Williams.
Oh, yes. I know Pita.
And I said, yeah. Pita, hit that note and let's do it. And we did, and I sounded pretty good. It was my version of Happy Birthday.
Okay.
But it was very nice.
Very nice.
I enjoyed it. It was great.
Very nice.
I think that the audience was a little surprised. Like, wow, I didn't know Sheila could sing.
Yeah.
Was that kind of like President Obama when he hit a note or two a few weeks ago?
Exactly.
And, yeah, he did. He surprised everybody, didn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Well, good. Well, I love your voice. I always have.
Absolutely. You have a wonderful voice. You can come over anytime and talk to me and I'll fall asleep.
Not necessarily. Some people want to associate it with sexy, mm-hmm. but I associate it more with just relaxed.
Soothing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very soothing.
Exactly. That's
it is
word.
Very
yeah.
soothing.
Talk to Sheila. I had a radio show, too.
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
People are calling her with all sorts of questions. Wanting to discuss their issues. You know, so
yeah. You had a delay, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah. That's always good.
Hold on. Just a
moment. I hope we have one here. Yeah.
Exactly.
So, what inspired you to get into communications and radio?
Believe it or not, as a kid, probably 8 years old or so, I always grabbed a microphone or pretending to have a microphone, and I just loved public speaking. Even as a kid, in church, I would read, you know, you take your little script for your poem that you read at church on Easter Sunday, and I got up there with ease, and I thought, oh, wow. As I started getting older, I realized, this is easy for me. I enjoy speaking and reading, and I have no mic fright whatsoever. I can get up in front of a crowd of two or three or hundreds, thousands.
Yeah.
So that was what inspired me. And actually, I wanted to be a television anchor.
Oh.
And I'll tell you, God knows best. And here I am. I got into radio instead. Mm-hmm. I got my first job offered in radio in 1983.
Great.
And I took it, and I never looked back, thinking, well, I guess this was God's way of saying, no, it's not television. Mm. You were close.
Except you could have done television because you don't have a radio.
Well, I did a little bit of television.
Yeah.
It was a cable station around St. Louis, and it was sort of like the today's version of Show Me St. Louis.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And or what's the other one on the...
Good.
You got me. I'm retired, so I don't look at all.
Yeah, but today's St. Louis or something like that. I forgot.
But I'm
anyway.
Familiar with that one.
Yeah.
But you know, but I was thinking if you do radio, I have a confession to make. Radio was and remains my first love.
Exactly.
Yeah. It really does. It has its own. I don't know. If there's something about radio that
it
I enjoyed, that you can be very personal. And very personable without having to put on an air. And that's not to say that people put on an air on TV, but there are some who do.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You can be who you are
and
not worry about, well, did I wink? Did I frown? worry about that.
Exactly.
You know? And that comes through, I think, when it comes through the radio if you're really good at it. And there are a lot of people around who are really good at it. And there are a lot of people around who are really bad at it.
That's right.
Exactly. Hey, the truth is the truth, you know?
Yeah,
so anyway, I don't mean to denigrate anyone, but I love radio, and I still do.
I love it immensely, mm-hmm. and I wish that something would break soon. I've always wanted to own my own radio station.
You sound like me. We need to talk.
Radio station and club.
Oh, wow.
Club radio. That's one of my old resumes.
Yeah.
Where you would actually house the administrative area of the radio station on the top level of the club restaurant below.
That actually
and
sounds
a lot of people
cool.
that have always wondered, well, what does she look like or what does he look like? on radio, you could actually be able to look while you're eating or dancing or whatever it is,
look up
and actually see the announcer on the air during their particular segment.
Mm-hmm. That reminds me of at Westport, they have at Westport Plaza, I don't know if
KTRS,
you...
KTRS?
Yes,
KTRS. I've worked there.
Okay, great. Yeah, where you can
There are many
see.
Places I haven't worked.
I'm sure. I'm sure, and that reminds me of that concept where you can see, but also be eating or shopping or doing something else as well. Yeah. Very cool.
I actually interned over at Channel 5, and while I was there, I got offered a job in radio, and I just took it.
I don't blame you.
Great. Gotta go where your opportunity
was,
is.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I always loved music. I was, you know, raised around jazz and R&B music with my two socialite parents.
Very nice. And I know, Donn, you recently retired from the Missouri History Museum after 7 years, I believe, as the Director of Communications. What were some of the tasks involved?
Well, I think the major thing was to put the museum in the forefront, because technically, the Missouri History Museum didn't exist really until about 20 years ago, and it had actually, the building that it was in was actually not the History Museum at that time. It was the Jefferson Memorial, and it was the first building built as a memorial to Thomas Jefferson, celebrating the Lewis and Clark expedition. So So my job was to make people understand that this was now the Missouri History Museum, and also the underlying job also was to interest African Americans in history, you know, and I hope I accomplished some of that while I was there. We had a number of exhibits that I thought that were very, very good, and then we had the famous Twilight Tuesdays that we hopped up.
Yeah, I like Twilight Tuesday.
People loved and still love.
And still love.
Yeah.
And so while I didn't create it, I think I tried to enhance it so that people would have a wider variety of music to enjoy. And what I found was that it was cross-cultural. You know, it didn't matter who we had there. Sometimes we'd have Elvis impersonators or impressionists. We had one time we brought in a group that mirrored the Beatles. The same people showed up for them that showed up for Motown. because it was such a generally good time, you know. So that was one of the things. And the other, of course, was to consolidate the communications inside the building. And that's what most directors of communications have to do, to make sure that each department is communicating with the other, you know, so that you don't get these isolations that sometimes can happen inside organizations. And all in all, working for Robert Archibald was a good thing. I was very pleased to have worked there, and when you know, I decided I don't want to work anymore.
Oh yeah.
I just stopped working.
Well, at least you had that, you know. Yeah. At least you knew when you, you know, when
well,
it was
you know,
time.
You know what it is, and you know, it's something that because it was so different from what I was accustomed to doing. I was accustomed to being the center of attention as an anchor. You are whether you want to be or not.
That's right.
Absolutely.
And so, you know, it was nice being in the background. You know, it was very nice being in the background and not having to be out front and say, you
oh,
know,
sure.
I'm the face of. I was,
sure.
You know, and that's it. Believe it or not, when you've been out front for a while, unless you have this gigantic ego, you know, it gets tiresome.
True.
It really does.
Sure.
So I was like, hey, this is cool. So 7 years I spent there, had a little office up on the corner of the building there, you know, kind of hidden away. It was cool. It was very cool.
Very nice. And Sheila, you have a business enterprise today called Sheila's Voice.
Exactly.
And tell me more about Sheila's Voice.
Well,
I mean,
voice.
I hear your voice. But
if you need a voice for whatever occasion, for whatever instance it may be, I think you should call Sheila.
Great.
Sheila's Voice. Radio, television, commercials, telephone recording services for corporations, personal and business. Movies, theater, film, you know, just you name it, I can do it. Narrating, commentary, MC, entertainment.
Great.
Concerts.
Yeah.
Which,
yeah.
All of these things I've done. And hopefully, the grace of God will continue to be able to do.
Absolutely.
Because there is a market.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, definitely.
You'd
oh, yeah.
be surprised.
Definitely.
I get friends that, hey, Sheila, I really want you to put your name, your voice on my cell phone. I don't want to be on my business line, you know, which I have. So there are personal accounts too. Some people don't like their voices.
You're right. I've done that.
To use someone else's voice. Yeah. Or just the delivery and the professionalism.
Right.
About that.
If I'm ever having a bad day and I need to record my voicemail or something on the show.
Exactly. For some big event.
Exactly.
This is here.
Exactly. I will keep that in mind. Absolutely.
So
I will
keep that in mind. Some of the offers that I get that people want me to do.
Yes, I could imagine. Some of them are a bit unsavory at times. I mentioned there are things you have to turn down. But voiceover is great work.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I would love to do
animation.
Oh, I'd love to do animation.
See, you know, and thank God I know muy poquito español.
Oh,
so
good.
I can speak a little bit of Spanish.
Good.
You know, and I can maybe put on the Indian accent. My name is Sheila. no problem. I can do a lot of different variations of my voice.
That's good. It's always great to have.
Sometimes I can even sound like a man.
Ah. Hey, you know what? The more variety, the better. Not knocking it.
So I'm an actress at heart, really. I am. So I think that all comes to play in radio as well.
It has to.
You have to wear a lot of different hats.
Absolutely.
You'd be surprised.
Absolutely.
I fooled a lot of folks on the air, and as well as answering the phone.
That can be amusing.
Exactly.
Very amusing. So I know you all are both, as well as myself, are involved with an event at the Black Radio Personality Awards next weekend. Tell me more about this event and what it celebrates.
I'm going to turn
over to Sheila for a while. Long awaited. All of the radio personalities in the Metro St. Louis area, including, of course, East St. Louis, all the surrounding areas, Blacks that have started out, such as Wiley Price Jr., was the first pioneer in radio. And I can go on down the line with folks that need to be recognized. We've never been recognized. And there's 128 of us, to be exact, that I could count. And sorry if I've missed anyone, but I was assisting with the committee to pull this together. But people like Lou Father Times, current Columbus Gregory, Scotty Lawrence, Hank Thompson, yourself, myself, Bernie Hayes, of course, who is our public's guest speaker, of course, for the show.
Yeah.
And Jockenstein, Gentry Trotter, Leo Cheers, at used to EDB. I mean, you know, we could go on and on. There's going to be just a wonderful group of radio personalities that I haven't seen, that have moved away, that have lived here. St. Louis has always been that connection, that mid-city connection for all radio personalities at one point or another have come through here.
You're right. You know, it's funny you would say that, and I'll tell you something, Lesley, that you're a bit young to remember. You wouldn't remember these things, but there was a time when you had to have a Midwestern voice to even be on the radio.
What's a Midwestern voice?
Well, that's no accent.
Okay. See? Maybe you're
right. No, I'm serious.
We may not really have that.
Well, and that's what they used to do because they didn't want to offend, especially when you got on the national scene, they didn't want to offend the rest of the country. So if a person had a Southern accent or a person had a Boston accent, pardon me, you know, or a person was from Minnesota. They said, oh, we'll be offended. Well, of course, now that's all changed. But for, I guess, the first 40, 50 years. I mean, first of all, you had the very stilted, you know, this is, you know, H.B. Colton board and all that business.
Exactly.
You had these very stilted voices, and then you had normal voices, but very, very solid voices, but no accents. You know, Bob Barker's a good example of the Price is Right.
Yes.
He came out of Southwest Missouri, the Springfield area, as a matter of fact, and because he lost his accent, you know, he got the job. Of course, he was a very handsome
successful guy,
too. And
yes,
now he's very successful,
yeah.
Very successful fellow. So, I mean, the point was that it used to be a time when you couldn't. And so for African-Americans, it was even rougher because you had to balance it, I think, between being letting everybody know you were Black and at the same time, you know, speaking the King's English properly.
Absolutely.
You know, we had a tough job, didn't we? But people would call you up and say, are you white?
Yeah.
No. No, I'm not. Well, you sound white. It would depend
on.
Now, there's nothing wrong with being white, but my point is,
exactly,
there was this confusion that would occur.
That's right.
Yeah.
And they were either shocked to see the face
right
behind the voice.
Exactly.
Which is always something that's a surprise. surprises me.
But, I've gotten that as well. We've been talking on the phone
exactly.
with people and then met them. Oh!
And then to go on about this show, Leslie, is that there are those that, of course, that have gone on before us that we'd love to honor, such as Gracie. And, of course, I mentioned Leo Cheers and Jockenstein, Sweet Charlie, and
I work with all those people.
Spider Burks.
I work with all of them. I had the great pleasure of working with them. So I think it's wonderful that they're being recognized. And to include me in the bunch makes me feel even more, because these people are giants. You know,
absolutely.
And I stand on their shoulders. You know,
absolutely.
I do.
You know.
Yes, I do too.
Yeah.
It's an honor for me to be in participation. And to think that we were some of the first to expose their music on black radio stations.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know? And all the wonderful people that will come and support us, all those avid listeners, and you know, it just goes on and on, of all the wonderful people that will be there and the reason behind it.
Absolutely.
Recognition, it's simple as that.
You know, I think we better tell them where it is.
And the, you're right. And the new announcers that are on the air today, the younger generation, they're not aware of us.
They have no history.
Some of us. There's no history behind it.
Exactly.
So we want them to come out and be supportive and get a chance to meet and mingle with.
If you know where it is, it's the Polish Heritage Center.
Yep.
And that's on St. Louis Avenue, 20th Street. North 20th Street, actually, but right off St. Louis Avenue. I've been to that place before when they were at their, it is, and they have this Polish festival.
Exactly.
They have a Polish festival there in the summertime. It's terrific. Absolutely terrific. But it won't be that. We'll be there. You know, we'll be there, the Black Radio Personality Awards. And
the Sentinel newspaper is putting this all together.
Right.
To give a plug for the Sentinel newspaper, a publisher, Mr. Mike Williams. I came to him one day with this idea, and he ran with it.
Great.
And he said, let's do it. I said, okay. Because I talked to other former colleagues, and they too thought, hey, this is great. This is something that's definitely needed. And it's been so far so good. And we can only wish for the best.
I'm looking forward to it. And I will be the mistress of ceremonies for the event with Ron Ramey, which is the master of ceremonies.
Yes,
and he's very talented.
Talented.
He's
very much.
Funny.
And my dear friend, too.
Very much.
And Ron's been through a lot, so I'm glad to see he's up and about.
Oh, yes. I've heard. So it'll be very nice to host that and kind of move that along with him.
We're
excited
to have
him. Oh, yes, definitely. Yeah. Definitely. Definitely. Yeah. I feel honored.
Oh, my God. Wait till you hear Ron. He's
I'm sure he's hilarious.
As well.
I'll probably be laughing throughout.
Dancing, Ron, of course, Don Cornelius.
Oh,
with the
great.
Soul Train line to kind of kick off the dancing at the end.
Oh, that's great.
And
I'm excited.
Door prizes, cash bar.
Wonderful.
It should be great.
Wonderful.
And people ask, well, what should I wear? I mean, well, you know, I go all the way with it. So
yeah.
I'm going to wear a gown.
Be extravagant. Be extravagant.
It's black tie. And, like I said, we're anticipating a wonderful turnout.
Where can anyone who's still interested in attending, where can they go to find tickets?
Please contact the St. Louis Metro Sentinel Journal. And that number is 314-531-2100.
Oh, you've got that down.
Very good. Essentially spokesperson for the paper.
Great, great.
Well, they've been doing great work over the years.
They really
have.
And, you know, it's another one of those publications that you're very proud of. You know,
very much.
One of the pioneering publications, and they do good work, and they do good work in the community.
Absolutely.
Yeah. How can you knock that?
And it's also not too late. Let me just say a plug here. The Sentinel is also still accepting sponsorships. So if anyone is interested in being a sponsor, you know, we are more than welcome to have you contact the same number.
Great.
It's not too late. The cutoff for the newspaper print is on Monday.
Great. Well, everyone, please check out. I have information. I know some of my viewers are also on my Facebook. I have this information on the event on my Facebook page, as well as check out the Sentinel Journal for more information, tickets. It should be a wonderful event, honoring some great people and great people in attendance, such as you two and others. So please come out. Unfortunately, we're going to have to wrap up this first part, and after break, we're going to have on Roger Hunt. I did want to thank both of you for taking the time and coming out to the show. And I look forward to speaking
it's
to you.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Lesley.
Definitely.
In advance.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, right. I think you got a very bright future, too. So thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm honored.
Speaking voice as well.
Thank you.
I say all the time, God gives us gifts, and we definitely need to use them.
Amen.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I also want to thank my sponsor. The show sponsor is AAA Quality Painting, painting service with careful attention to detail for both homes and businesses. To ask questions on AAA services or set up a consultation, please call 314-882-0215. And we have my sponsor banner right here.
Right above your head.
right above your head, Sheila. So please check them out and stay tuned. This next we will have on Roger Hunt. We'll go to a break. See you soon.
Don't you know?
If you want to see the best entertainment around town, check out my show, Lesley on the Town, Thursdays 8 to 9 p.m. on iWatchRadio.com. Back live on iWatchRadio.com, Lesley on the Town, and I am here with model, actor, and host of the new TV series, The Spoken Word, Roger Hunt. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you for inviting me.
Absolutely. It's always a pleasure to talk to you, and now we're doing it live.
Yes, exactly.
On the air. So, Roger, how long have you been in entertainment, and what inspired you to get into the world of acting and modeling?
It's interesting because I actually started in 2010, believe it or not. I was approached by Pro Scout.
Oh, wow.
For modeling, and I attended a Pro Scout event that in Chicago in December of 2010. I wasn't selected as a model, but I continued and got very excited about the possibility of becoming a model. I hit the gym very frequently and hard, and then on top of that, April of actually last year, 2011, I was approached with an entertainment company. I got signed with a modeling agency here in St. Louis.
Great.
I signed with an entertainment company here in St. Louis. I signed also, and this happened in March, April, and May, I also signed on to do a film, also with a film writer. All in 2011, everything happened so fast, progressively so fast, and I was very aggressive in my venture to become a model and actor. So, and that's really kind of how it started.
Great. And if you had to choose between acting or modeling to pursue as a career, which would you choose over the other and why?
I love them both, but I have to be honest. I love the acting, the art of acting. You know, watching characters on TV and in sitcoms and movies and productions and plays, it gives you more of appreciation at actually what that person goes through, you know, getting into the character, changing of who you are naturally into someone else. And I kind of had to learn that on a commercial shoot I've done for General Motors this past summer, you know.
Oh, wow.
You know, changing your character role and everything and forgetting that. And I had to tell myself, I'm not Roger Hunt anymore. I'm actually playing this character for this company now. So, and you have to get in character mode, you know, reading the scripts, discipline yourself to read the scripts and actually have to get in that form or that character that you're playing and presenting yourself as that particular person for that project.
Wow.
And I love the fashion world as well. I mean, the modeling is fun and exciting, but I think it's more adventurous in the acting world too.
Exactly. Acting, you never know. You know, you can change it up. You can have variety.
Right. And actually, as models, sometimes we think that you're just modeling, but at the same time, we also have to be actors.
It's true.
In the modeling.
Very
because
true.
If you're representing a product or brand, you have to represent that product in the way that you have to, may have to act or present it some type of way. So So yeah, it goes both ways, even in the modeling where you still have to do some form of acting too.
Absolutely. It reminds me of, I was watching, I think, an older America's Next Top Model episode yesterday, and they were actually having where the models were representing a CoverGirl makeup, the products, and they did
exactly
have to act on
see,
screen.
Exactly,
I mean,
yeah.
Even though it was, some were still shot, some were commercial, but
you still have to
they,
do that.
It was still acting.
And, so,
was
and that's kind of how the industry is going today. So you have to do some of both.
Yeah. The more skills and talents within entertainment, the better. You know, sometimes in even other areas, sometimes dancers make great models because they're used to movement,
fluidity, versatility.
Yeah,
exactly.
So in terms of acting, do you do both stage and commercials, stage acting and commercials and films, or primarily
I'm
one
I'm doing
versus
commercials.
The other?
I'm doing more commercial work. I'm doing some. I'm in the process of doing a film. And I guess we're going to talk about that a little bit later.
Sure.
I'm co-starring in a film. We've kind of put it on hold from last late fall because of the seasons change, seasonalities change. So we have to start pick up later in the summer or the spring and pick back up with that. And actually the television show I'm going about to take on as well.
Yes.
So there's kind of a lot going on with me right now. So I'm just excited about all of
great.
It.
That's great. That's a blessing. And we're actually going to now watch a clip of you, Roger, acting in a film, probably the one that you mentioned.
Right, 26.2.
Yes, 26.2, that is currently in production. So we'll show that clip. Hopefully it can be pulled up.
This is freaking weird, man.
What do you see?
I don't see shit. I got a towel on my face.
You're at mile 24. You look up at the pace clock, and what do you see?
Man, come on.
Focus, damn it! Do you want to do this?
Yeah, okay.
No, it's not okay. We've been training for 2 weeks, and you're still slower than a dry creek. The marathon is 4 weeks away, and you have to run 20 miles in 2 hours and 46 minutes.
Maybe I should just quit.
Yeah, you know what? Quit.
Hey.
God knows you're good at
hey,
it.
Hey, watch
it. Hey, I don't have time for
wait
this.
Wait a second. Hey, wait a second. Come here, wait.
Hey, wait a sec. I know you. You're damaged good. This isn't about winning a race. It's about becoming who you gave up on a long time ago. Look at me. Do you really believe you're a loser?
I'm not a loser.
A quitter? You train your mind to run a marathon, you can train your mind to run 26.2, and you can train it to be whomever you want to be and who you were meant to be. Quitters never win, and winners never quit. Which one are you going to be?
Exactly. Oh, that was an awesome clip.
Yeah.
Tell me what the film's about.
The film is actually about a young man. I play the character of Troy, and then co-star with Todd Starwater, Walter, which is Sonny. He lost his passion and dream back in Alton, Illinois, Alton High School, and he was always a loser in everything that he tried. So as we became adults, some years later, 40-something years later, as it is that Sonny decides that he wants to run a marathon. So in doing that, I become Sonny's trainer. And so I'm kind of a drill sergeant in the picture and everything. And at the end, just a long story short, Sonny does become the winner of the Chicago Marathon, and then he qualifies for the Boston Marathon. So it's a very good film, but then there's some Sonny always quit everything that he put his hands, his job, his marriage, you name it, he quit. His family, he was just a quitter. And this was one thing that he decided that he was going to win at, even losing his best friends and quitting on his friends and things of that nature. So it has a good, very good storyline. You have to see it. You know, I can't, I don't want to tell too much of the story, though, but it is a very good film that should be coming out in 2012, later in 2012.
Well, great.
So hopefully it'll be featured at the Indie Fall Festival, Film Festival here in St. Louis.
Definitely. Let me and everyone, I'm sure I know you'll be letting
everyone
know.
We'll definitely keep you posted as well on one of the many projects that's going on right
Absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely. Well, that's great. And we're going to take a short break and show a commercial for the River City Casino
oh, wow.
ad that you're featured in, which I think is very cool. So We are going to go to break, and after this River City commercial, we're going to talk about the awesome new show and series that you're involved with. So stay tuned, viewers, and we'll see you after break.
Yes.
Very, very cool. That made me hungry.
Yeah, I was just telling Lesley, you know, we ate. That was one of my best commercials because we got to eat so much. I mean, it was fun. We had a lot of fun. And it's interesting because a lot of times you go on set, sometimes you're supposed to be the extra, and then you end up being the principal on the set. So it's just one of the terms we use in the Molly world. Of course, you know that. So, But I end up being one of the principal characters in that commercial, so which was great. I just had fun with the client overall there with River City and Lumiere. So it was a fun project as well.
Great. Yeah, that was very cool. I was like, oh, I know that guy. So you're also a host, and I know we're going to soon talk about an awesome new show you're involved with. But before we talk about that, there's something that's associated. Who's Next to Blow? So you're involved with this. What is Who's Next to Blow Live about? And
Who's Next to Blow actually is an umbrella of several different projects that's going to be taken on. One being the spoken word. We're going to launch that one first, and then under that also it will be Who's Next to Praise Him, which will be the gospel portion of Who's Next to Blow. The R&B hip-hop section, and these are all going to feature indie genre artists coming up that want to make a start. So we want to give them a platform so that they can present their craft, their skill, their art. And so in doing this, we figure this is the best way to do that under the Who's Next to Blow label, Who's Next to Blow Live, and again, launching right here out of St. Louis. So it's very exciting time for artists who want to come on board and be a part of our entertainment company through Midwest Flawless Entertainment, based out of St. Charles, Missouri here. An awesome producer that's heading up the company and everything. So, and I've actually been with the company for a year now. So
great.
It's been great. It's been a journey. Our challenges and everything, like any other entertainment business, you know, you have your ups and downs in the modeling and entertainment acting world as well. So, but we strive very hard and diligently to make sure we put on classy products or projects that we present to the public and to the viewers that are out there.
Awesome. So, yeah. Very cool. And there's an event coming up on March 2nd related to Spoken Word in the series. What's taking place at this event?
March 2nd and 3rd, we will launch officially, and I am so excited, the Spoken Word under Who's Next to Blow Live, the Spoken Word event. It will be at...
Got a flyer, too.
2727 South 12th Street at the Mad Art Gallery. Okay.
Great.
There will be a national casting call, and there's actually a website with all of this information on there. If you go to
it's below your head, I think.
www.whosnexttoblowlive.com. And on that website, there's information about sponsorship, volunteers, auditioning, ticket information, all of that. So the general public is invited to the show. Again, we're launching here in St. Louis. And then from St. Louis, and before I even get to that, because I'm going to get ahead of myself,
because
I'm excited.
Yeah, whatever.
From there, go with the flow. You know, there's going to be a national casting call on March 2nd. So what participants or potential contestants would like to do if they want to come out to the national casting call, they're definitely welcome to do that and come out and audition. We will videotape and we will film you on that day as well, you know, as you're going through the process of auditioning. There'll probably be some interviews and some Q&A sessions with the contestants as well. And then six fortunate contestants will be asked to come back on Saturday, March 3rd, to actually be in the taping of the television show.
Great.
Okay. And in doing so, that would be at the Mad Art Gallery at 2727 South 12th Street. And then from there, the networks that we're looking at right now, and I'll just say HBO, one of the networks, and possibly one of the other, some other major networks as part of hosting these great shows. From there, once we finish in St. Louis, we will culminate and go on a 7-city tour.
Awesome.
Yeah, so those cities include, if I can keep them in my head, San Francisco, LA, Minneapolis, Chicago, Detroit, Memphis, Atlanta, and then launching, finishing up in St. Louis.
Wonderful.
So that is the plan, that is the goal of ours, to get all this done and get it done in a timely manner. So, and because then after that, there's another project that we're working on as well.
Oh,
too.
Wow.
So there's a lot in the hopper.
There's a lot of good stuff.
There's a lot of projects going on, so that we just got to keep moving and keep making things happen.
There's a lot of good stuff. So how is the show that you're involved with, The Spoken Word, how is it unique? And what about it will bring something different to the table?
It's unique in a way because The Spoken Word, I believe, you know, is hidden talent. It's a hidden underground talent of artists that are out there that they have stories to tell. They have a ministry. It's a ministry. They minister to people's hearts, to people's souls, people that are struggling with various issues or have struggled or have gone through, you know, child abuse, molestation, rape, incest,
oh, wow.
You know, so they talk about all that and then just talk about things that have happened just in general life. But other people that have gone through that, you know, who cannot get up on a platform and tell their story, they're able to do that in poetry. Some of it is can be erotic, some of it can be very subtle, but it just depends on the artist's style and how they present it. But it's a good way to inform and to minister to people's hearts and to their souls and right. actually tell and actually help the healing of someone else that have gone through some of the same similar situations and cannot express themselves through the spoken word, you know. So
wow.
These artists that are going to present and come out and do that, I think they'll do a very awesome job in doing that and presenting that, not only here in St. Louis, but, you know, around across the country.
Well, that's yeah. wonderful.
So I'm excited about that.
That's wonderful. I can't wait till that.
So again, another platform for these artists to be showcased and the spotlight to be shined on them. And hopefully that takes their careers even further.
Good.
To do something else as well.
Good, absolutely. Well, that's great. I can't wait for that. So I'll be in touch with you.
Yeah, definitely.
HBO and
so March
other
3rd,
networks.
March 3rd at the Mad Art Gallery at 7 p.m. You know, we want St. Louis to come out and support because this is happening in your hometown.
Yes.
You know, a TV show launching out of your backyard. You know, how often does that happen?
I'll definitely stop by.
You know, so that definitely, yeah.
Great. And got about 10 more minutes, but we're going to take a break and play a little music video, Make You Say, by Common okay. and Kanye West. And then after that, we'll, I wish I could ask you a million questions, but we'll definitely hit some key points before we wrap up. So we're going to take a break with some Kanye West and Common, and we will see you soon.
I'll make a say. When I
poker face, poker face,
I make a say. What up? Me first. She wanna have whatever she like. She can if she bring her friend, and we can have one hell of a night through the day. Hey, I mean staring like a creeper, cause you got a beeper. I mean you probably might be saying you ain't jogging either, but man, old girl got a fat old. Yeah, the type to make you tell her just dance. And fuck the mother, cause you down for her. Fuck the mother, cause she down for the stick. The mother, so she down for some. The mother, cause she down for the chicken love. I'm hoping she a rider when it's said and done. Now I ain't got a trouble but the to like her. But me and mommy know who can really make her go. Yeah, yeah.
Poker face,
poker
face.
I make a say. Yeah.
all, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. She said she want whatever she like. She said she gon' bring her friend. And we gon' have a hell of a night. Through the day, I made her say, hold up, born in 88. How old is that? Old enough, I got seniority with the sorority, so that explain why I love college, getting in the library because I love knowledge. When you use your medulla oblongata and give me scoliosis until I comatosis and do it while I'm sleep, yeah, a little osmosis, and that's my commandment. You ain't gotta ask Moses. More champagne, more toasts, more damn planes, more coasters, and fuck a bus to Benz, park like Rosa Oza.
Poker face, but poker
face. I make it
say. Oh, 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 oh.
Yeah.
Poker face, but poker face.
I make it say. She says she want whatever she like, but you gotta bring your friend, and we can have a hell of a night through the day. She blamed it on the alcohol. She had her head did it, was bound to fall down, down for a damn cutty. Already said it, a poker Facebook, I already read it. But man, it's gooder than the music. Electro body, known to flow fused as a stripper from the south, looking for a payday. Said, you should do it for the love like Ray J. But they say, you be on that conscious tip. Get your head right and get up on this conscious. I embody everything from the golly to the party. It's the way I was raised on the south side safari, so. When I
poker face, but poker face,
I make it say,
oh, oh, oh,
yeah. When I
poker face, but poker face.
That's true. Well, we are back, and we just have a couple more minutes. But before we wrap up, I wanted to ask you, are there any important upcoming events you have going on and that you want to let the viewers know of besides the spoken word event?
The spoken word event, there's another event in June that we're actually kind of simultaneously working on. It's called Gospel Goes Classical, and that will be at Pyle Symphony Hall June 20th, and that will feature Prophetess Juanita Bynum.
Oh, cool.
Gospel artist Mr. Byron Cage, another local artist, the Michael Atchison Singers, and there may be another one in addition to that. So that's coming up in June. So that's one of the events. And then in addition to the spoken word, we're also looking at doing something, another twist simultaneously, and while we're gonna record or do the first taping of the show, we're probably gonna end up doing this another series called Up Close and Personal.
Okay.
So that's gonna be another special edition and a twist to the spoken word. We just decided to do that today. So that's another show. And we're actually going to launch that with a local network.
Oh, great.
In St. Louis. So it'll be with a local network in St. Louis. So again, there's a lot of exciting things that are happening with us and with our entertainment company. We have a great marketing team, PR team, great producer, whose heart and soul is in the whole projects that we're coming up with. Have a great consultant that's working with us and has our back and support as well. So that's all good.
Good.
It's very important that you have that too in this business.
Oh yes, very much so. Yeah. Very much so. And how can people keep up with what you have going on? I know you have Facebook. Do you have another website?
Facebook,
Twitter?
Is Roger Hunt, and it's R-O-G-E-R Hunt, H-U-N-T. Twitter is Radstar, R-A-D-S-T-A-R-R 3. And
I
that's
love
actually
your Twitter name.
For my three sons, Roger, Aaron, and Darius. Oh. And that's stars just me. I gave that name to myself back when I was in high school. So, and three was for my three sons. And then also on, you can go to www.whosnexttoblowlive.com or info@whosnexttoblowlive.com as well.
Great.
So again, come check us out. Go to the website. There's vital information on there that tells about the show and everything. Sponsors, we would love to have them.
Yes.
Come on board this exciting project that's launching out of St. Louis, the TV show and everything, not only for the spoken word, but also for Gospel Coast Classical as well. So it's a great opportunity for corporate America to even get involved with that and sponsor
Wonderful.
Local sponsors as well to become a part of that, you know,
Wonderful.
So and showcase your products and services and get your name out there as well.
Sure.
So we can do a twofold there, okay? So we need your sponsors, we need volunteers, you know, those who want to get a part, get in the industry and kind of see how things work behind the scenes. There's a lot of work that goes on. You know, even put on the fashion show, as you know, but then
oh, yes.
also doing a, it's definitely a TV show. A lot of times people see the finished product on the air, but what goes into putting that product together, they don't see that.
Yeah.
You know, so the magic of cinematography and television is amazing. So once you get to see that finished, it makes a great deal. And then you have a great product to see, to show to the viewers.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And speaking of sponsors, I also want to plug and thank my sponsor again, AAA Quality Painting, painting service with careful attention to detail for both homes and businesses. To ask a question on AAA services or set up a consultation, please call 314-882-0215. I think I'm blocking the sign with my head, but it's right here, my sponsor banner, so all the information is there. And they are awesome. Scott, which is the owner, is not only great for sponsoring the show, I appreciate that, but an awesome person. So thank you again, AAA Quality Painting. And thank you.
Thank you for having me.
For coming on
the
show.
Very informative and everything. So
yes.
We'll have to do a follow-up for sure.
Absolutely. I'll be following up with you very often, very often. And yes, everyone, please remember to check out the Who's Next to Blow Live
Who's Next to Blow Live
on March 2nd.
March 2nd and
okay.
3rd. The show is actually on the 3rd. But if you want to come out, we're going to have some radio personalities there as well. So
great.
It would be advertised on the radio. It would be advertised on the three major networks here in St. Louis as well. So there'll be more information coming. Also on Facebook, you can hit me up on Facebook. It's fine. Roger Hunt. It's yes. already been blown up anyway. So but that's great. That's a great start. So we're looking forward to having all of St. Louis come out and be a part of this great venture and this great show.
Oh, yes. Great. Well, that's a wonderful event. Everyone, again, for Don Johnson and Sheila Reed that came on earlier, another plug for the Black Personality Awards event at the Polish Heritage Center, and that is next Saturday. So please feel free to come out to that. I am one of the hosts for that event, so that will be an honor, as I'll be surrounded by pioneers in radio, so I'm excited. But yes, please check out both of those events. Stay in touch with Roger and myself. And as always, check out Lesley on the Town live on iWatch Radio, 8 to 9 p.m. And check out my YouTube channel where you can check out the archives and keep up to date with the recorded shows, even if you're not able to see the show live. And my YouTube channel is Lesley on the Town, the name of the show. So please check that out. And this show should be up recorded in about a day or so. So if you missed it, you won't be hearing me saying this right now, but you will be able to check out my YouTube channel. So again, thanks, Roger.
Thanks,
viewers. Thank you, Sheila, Reed, and Don, who came on earlier. And we will see you soon.
Thank you.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out and I'll lay your ship bare. See, I'll leave with every piece of you. Don't underestimate the things that I will do. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and it's bringing the dark. The scars of your love remind me of us. They keep me thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah. the sky.